Man, I will tell you what. This is awkward. Mike here, one go short play. Having another go at doing some voice on one of my gameplays. A third go in this case. This is Cytron by Psygnosis for the Commodore Amiga. Awesome Psygnosis logo. Psygnosis based in Liverpool. I think I've got a feeling this was made by then. I might be totally wrong about that. Who knows? When I was a kid in Liverpool, I really wanted to work for these, and pretty much any other games company that was out there. They were kind enough to let me go and take some photos of their place when I was doing some study or other during me college or university days. Very cool people. Based in Wavertree at the time, they had a big, massive Psygnosis owl at the top of the building. It was brilliant. Now, I have fast forwarded through that story a bit, and there was a lot of details I left out, mainly because this is the third time I'm doing this video. My PC is a bit rubbish. It needs updating quite badly. It's about 6 years old now, and the USB ports are all starting to go on it, namely the one attached to my microphone, which means that at various points in this video, the mic has just died partway through. So I'm kind of hanging in there. I'm hoping this one will be the one. If it's not, I think I'm just going to record this game without me talking on it, because, man, really? Anyway, Cytron! This is cool. Wait for the drums. Ah, yeah. Oh, why didn't. You know what? You got like a bar of really good drums. Oh, look, there's like sound, music. Oh, I don't know what the buttons are. Let's hit fire and just start the game. I was going to put the music on throughout because I like it. But I think we'll just get to it. So, I thought this was all like based on the big chipboard, as you probably would, having just seen the front end. It kind of makes sense. But then we cut to this little bit of exposition, some kind of mega city style factory. There's obviously, my point is, there's obviously storyline to this game, as is often the case with Psygnosis games, all set in that kind of, is it Roger Dean sort of world, where everything's kind of, you know, windswept and deserty and slightly technological but organic. You know what I'm on about. Psygnosis. Yeah, there seems to be a lot of hidden depth to these games, and when you play them, really, you've got quite a simple gameplay experience. Shadow the Beast, I'm looking at you. But you know what I mean, guys. This one is no different there, really. It's not set on a chipboard, much as you would expect it to be by the graphics. I think, judging by the storyline snippets you get between levels, it's set in some kind of big factory, where you're rescuing humans from crazy robots, and then finding exits, and then blowing the tunnels behind you, nuking it from space. It's the only way to be sure, and all that. Of course, none of this is explained anywhere as actual storyline. It's just assumed knowledge. Now, that's cool. I like that. It gives it a bit of mystique. It kind of works for me. I think Psygnosis were masters at mystique. Now, this is interesting. See that there? Not a robot. That was a person. Hard to tell, wasn't it? Considering that the palette was pretty much the same as the robot. And my first go at this, I did just basically massacre the humans. I was one of these psycho robots, basically. And it was just because I couldn't tell one thing from another. And also, there was no kind of storyline offered. So, yeah, kind of winging it. If it moves, shoot it and all that. See that? Another person. But not a consistently stylized person to the other one. So I had to watch out for that. We live and learn. Psycho robots are pretty clear there. Now, there are some cool things about this game that I really love. I'll show you them in a minute. But for the most part, we're doing a bit of robot blasting. Get here, you. Get her. There we go. A bit of robot blasting, a bit of person rescuing, and a bit of cool time warp, space warp thingy jumping. And that's kind of cool. Right, here we go. Exposition. We're in some kind of tank. We're not a microchip at all. And we're moving from that bit to the next bit. And we're blowing the tunnel behind us. Now, that's as expressive as story gets, really, in, especially in sort of 16-bit era games. And I love that. That's, you know, you just do it by gesture, which is cool. There's no text to explain what's going on there. We just kind of wing it. So we're not on the chipboard. We're clearly in a tank, underground, and there's a person to rescue. Quick, get him before the mad robot does. And now the mad robots see me. Oh, and driven into the side of me. Because the controls aren't really that intuitive. But hey, we're talking a joystick with a single button. What more could you ask for? I don't know how these games got by without twin sticks. But they did. I mean, I know! Oh, skip that level then. I mean, admittedly, you get flown into quite a lot by random robots. Human. Massive conveyor belt. Whoa, this is cool. I do rather enjoy that. Simple things, eh? Oh, man. Yeah, so, we're a tank. We're rescuing people. We're killing robots. And then we're moving on. Now, there's a cool bit coming up, which allows me to show off what this tank can really do. If the little space warp stops sucking me in. Oh, kill robots, kill robots. I did basically walk into every single one of those. If we go down here, I think we might get that now. We might get what I'm on about. A little section of the game, and I got stuck before. Well, I say before, I mean on my first go of three. So that sounds game pretty well. In this little room, and I couldn't get out, and it was doing me nothing. And it was so unintuitive, I was just like, oh, come on, just give me a clue what to do. And this isn't the room, but I will be in it in a minute. In fact, shall we just leg it past all this? And see if we can get to it. Let's see if we can get to it without earning it. No, we clearly can't. Ow! Let's destroy these. And yeah, and then I hit the space bar and something amazingly cool happened. Which we're going to do in a minute. Once we've blown up all these dudes. And it kind of opened the game up, you know. And I like it when that happens. Ah, that's a baddie. It's a baddie house. Why aren't they jumping out of the houses and attacking me? I don't understand. I don't understand. Okay. Oh. No, that conveyor belt's letting me go nowhere. Okay. I'm a little bit... Oh, I'm gone. No, I'm not. What am I doing? There we go. Let's press buttons. In fact, I don't recognise this room. I might not have even been in this room before. I might have took a different route last time. I think I did. I think I've taken the wrong route. Oh well, that's a bit with me. Hey, that's it. Whatever it did, it turned that round the right way. Oh, okay then. That way. Aha, gotcha. Okay. Ow, ow, ow. Oh, another new room. Oh, I can't show off the thing I was going to show yet. Well, I could. I could just do it anyway. Ah, I don't like that. I'm going to die. Well, that sucked. Well, the thing I was going to do... Person. Ah, not person. See, I take issue with that. You can't really tell the people from some of the robot types. But before my time runs out on this video, I'm going to show you a very cool feature. Check this out. Little tank. How cool is that? And then... Oh, whoa. Haha. Alright, game over. Fairly opportune time. That is Cytron by Psygnosis. And it's actually quite good. Enjoyed that. Thank you very much for watching. See you in the next vid.